Good morning. Welcome to Manasquan United Methodist Church. My name is Reggie Albert. I'm honored to be the pastor here of this church, and today is graduation Sunday. Woohoo! And we also award the Norris Scholarship recipients today. So we are truly blessed. We have some of them here with us, some of them on video, and some of them have to work, some of them have taken desperately needed family vacations, so we are truly blessed to have our students here with us. The reopening team is continuing to evaluate our situation with COVID. We have the windows open for ventilation. We have the room sanitized. Masks are optional. We strongly recommend all those who are not vaccinated to wear a mask as encouraged by the CDC. And we will continue to do online services, and we will continue for now to do contact tracing. So we hope that you signed in. We hope that no one is sick. Don't come to church if you are sick, please. And we will continue to do our best to keep everyone safe. Wednesday morning's Bible studies are now hybrid on Zoom and in person. Tuesday night Bible study will be on summer hiatus after this week. We are having Thursday night worship services outside at 6 o'clock. Bring your lawn chair. We sing, we worship, we pray. It's a beautiful time together. We are also collecting things for Family Promise for families that are trying to get a home together. And we are collecting baby items like diapers, body wash and lotion, diaper cream, laundry detergent, feminine hygiene products, microwavable meals, breakfast bars, full-size sheets, whatever we can do to come alongside these families that are doing their best to find a home. The Blue Claws game on August 3rd, we're taking reservations for that. Just call the church office. The youth and children will be singing the national anthem. Our flowers this morning are from Judy Sambade's funeral on Friday, and we pray God's blessing upon the family. My friends, let us worship and celebrate and give thanks for all that God has done for us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Good morning and happy Sunday, everyone. It's good to see you all here. And welcome to those of you at home as well. Our opening song this morning is from Chris Tomlin. It's called I Will Follow. And so I chose it for all the graduates because no matter where you go in this world, God will be with you. And so I will follow. And yay today for AJ.
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow. Ooh, ooh, ooh. All your ways are good. All your ways are sure. I will trust in you alone. I am my
And you know you're allowed to sing. Amen?
Amen.
Okay.
Good morning, everyone, and congratulations to all our graduates, whether it's from preschool right through college, and we're happy to see so many of you here this morning. Let's begin worship with the call to worship. Please join me. With friends and strangers, with family and neighbors, we gather. Come among us, healing God, with that love which never ends. With faith reaching out to touch, with hearts straining to trust, we hope. Come among us, friend of the broken, with your compassion which makes us whole. With word and wonder, with silence and song, we wait. Come among us, dryer of our tears, to lift us to our feet to follow you. Let us pray. Holy One, you anoint us with living water so we may go to serve the world in these troubled days. You open our eyes so we will see everyone as our sisters and brothers. Seed planter, you place faith deep within us so we can bear witness to your just and loving kingdom. Your love regulates our hearts so we can welcome all in your name. Gentle Spirit, when we cannot see the way, you take us by the hand so we can step forward in faith into the kingdom. You fill us with hope so we can sing God's joy all of our days. In the name of the Creator, Savior, and Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Every time I try to make it on my own, every time I try to stand and start to fall, all those lonely roads that I had traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, friends I had were nowhere to be found. I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every moment of where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know it, I couldn't see it, there was Jesus. For this man who needs amazing kind of grace, for forgiveness at a price I couldn't pay, I'm not perfect, so I thank God every day. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment of where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus on the mountain, in the valleys,
there was Jesus
in the shadows of the alleys,
there was Jesus
in the fire, in the flood. Always is and always was. No, I never walk alone.
Never walk
you are always
alone.
There. like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Oh, every minute, every moment of where I've been and where I'm going. Even when I didn't know it, I couldn't see it. There was Jesus. There was Jesus.
The scripture reading this morning comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verses 7 through 9. There's a little intro so you can kind of set the scene for this. Paul is taking a collection for the church in Jerusalem. The growth was out in the suburbs, and the downtown church needs help. So he went from church to church asking for mission giving, and it sounds like he's buttering them up for a good offering. He writes to them saying this: "Now, as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in utmost eagerness, and in our love for you, we want you to excel also in this generous undertaking. I do not say this as a command, but I am testing the genuineness of your love against the earnestness of others. For you know the generous act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And our gospel, gospel lesson this morning comes from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 5, 21 through 43. Jesus crossed the lake again, and on the other side a large crowd gathered around him on the shore. Jairus, one of the synagogue leaders, came forward. When he saw Jesus, he fell at his feet and pleaded with him, "My daughter is about to die. Please come and place your hands on her so that she can be healed and lived." So Jesus went with him. A swarm of people were following Jesus, crowding in on him. A woman was there who had been bleeding for 12 years. She had suffered a lot under the care of many doctors and had spent everything she had without getting any better. In fact, she had gotten worse. Because she has heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his clothes. She was thinking, "If I can just touch his clothes, I'll be healed." Her bleeding stopped immediately, and she sensed in her body that her illness had been healed. At that very moment, Jesus recognized that power had gone out from him. He turned around in the crowd and said, "Who touched my clothes?" His disciples said to him, "Don't you see the crowd pressing against you, yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" But Jesus looked around carefully to see who had done it. The woman, full of fear and trembling, came forward. Knowing what had happened to her, she fell down in front of Jesus and told him the whole truth. He responded, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace, healed from your disease." While Jesus was still speaking with her, messengers came from the synagogue leader's house saying to Jairus, "Your daughter has died. Why bother the teacher any longer?" But Jesus overheard the report and said to the synagogue leader, "Don't be afraid, just keep trusting." He didn't allow anyone to follow him except Peter, James, and John, James' brother. They came to the synagogue leader's house, and he saw a commotion with people crying and wailing loudly. He went in and said to them, "What's all this commotion and crying about? The child isn't dead, she's only sleeping." They laughed at him, but he threw them all out. Then, taking the child's parents and his disciples with him, he went to the room where the child was. sorry. Taking her hand, he said to her, "Talitha kum," which means, "Young woman, get up." Suddenly, the young woman got up and began to walk around. She was 12 years old. They were shocked. He gave them strict orders that no one should know what had happened. Then he told them to give her something to eat. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
One of the wonderful stories of Jesus. We have some prayer concerns this morning. One I just heard about yesterday, someone that maybe many of you know. Paul Borden, husband of Barbara, died Thursday. His service will be this coming Wednesday, 4 to 8, with a service at 7:30. I think it's at Orenders. I will send that out on Constant Contact. So please be in prayer for the family. Also, we want to pray for Marilyn Harvey as she goes through testing. And keep in prayer Mary Boris, Margie Frazee, Barbara Andrews, Lisa's dad, Ron, babies with cancer, Donovan and Aria, online worshiper Don, and also those on the kidney transplant list, Andrea and Megan. And we want to continue to pray for Dave, who had surgery this past week, as well as those who are unemployed. And I'm sure our hearts go out to those in the Miami Tower collapse as they wait. So please keep those families in your prayers. Amen. Lord, you are indeed the healer of all our ills. We bring to you, Lord, our bodies, minds, and spirits, hurting and broken by the violence, ills, drama, and cares of a world separated from you. Breathe on us, O God, and make us whole. Give us the strength, health, wisdom, and knowledge found only through you. Send your life-giving spirit so that we may live our lives with courage and in profound peace of your love. Breathe on us, O God, and make us whole. O God, we ask that you sustain those who seek to alleviate the pain and suffering of this world. Give strength, courage, wisdom, and knowledge to all doctors and orderlies, nurses and clerks, psychiatrists, researchers, and all other medical caregivers, volunteers, and professionals. Send your life-giving spirit so that their ministries may bring healing and promote health. Be also with those who work with the wounds of societies and nations. Guide, protect, and strengthen our lawyers and police, chaplains and pastors, healthcare and social workers, politicians, military and diplomats, and all those who work for economic and social reform. Send your life-giving spirit that they may promote your loving grace. Bring healing to those in conflict and stability to those who are vulnerable. Breathe on us, O God, and make us whole. God so loved this world and this people that God sent Christ to suffer and die for us. Accept now that gift. Know that you are forgiven, reconciled, accepted, and loved. Breathe on me, O God, and make me whole. Breathe on us, O God, and make us whole. Let us pray as he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And amen. your microphone.
Right there.
Thank you. Well, our children's message today is about graduation. Those who have checked all the boxes off and celebrate a wonderful day throughout this season of graduation. So I wanted to start with the college graduates who were Norris recipients. And the first one is Kevin Dixon. And as you know, the family has moved to Rhode Island. He graduated summa cum laude in the honors program in computer engineering. He will work for Amazon writing code in the Kindle division. Yeah. Wow. So this is their graduation. So hello, Kim. We're glad to see you and your family. God bless Kevin and his next adventure. Okay, we have two others, Matthew Kimack and Stephen Karanassis. Yeah.
Matthew graduated from the College of New Jersey in May with a Bachelor of Arts degree in criminal justice. He's pursuing a career in law enforcement, and he's serving in the Coast Guard Reserves. Stephen is a senior. He's still a senior at Virginia Tech studying
a building. A super senior.
Yeah, studying building and construction, and he's working an internship with a firm in Washington this summer in his career field. And I just want to say very quickly, this scholarship, the money is fabulous. The church is very generous, and it means so much to the kids. But you have to also understand it's knowing they have this church behind them, the support that they have when they're away or wherever they are, they know that you have their back. And let me tell you, that means so, so much to them and to their parents. So thank you.
Amen. Amen. Christine is going to report on Courtney.
Courtney was home about a month ago, and so but in case you missed it, she just graduated the University of Tampa with a BA in fine arts with a concentration in painting, and she's establishing herself down in Tampa, so she's not planning on moving home. She loves it down there. She's painting murals all over the state of Florida. She was home to paint one in Asbury Park, and it'll be there all summer. It's on the corner of Cookman Avenue and Press Plaza.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Also, we have some that are church-related that aren't members of our church, but one is Barbara Andrews' granddaughter, Kirsten Campbell. She's graduated from Williams College in a double major, computer science and biology, and she also graduated with her master's in biology. Does anyone else feel like I'm just standing still? Are there any other college graduates? Okay. High school graduates, we're going to have a video when we show the Norris recipients. Rosemary Vanderneck graduated from Biotech High School, and she's our co-president of youth group. Tyler Michigan graduated from one of the brick high schools, and he's figuring out which trade he would like to go into, so we're proud of him. And Aaliyah, you want to come up? No, she said, oh. No. Aaliyah graduated from Manasquan High School. It's so good to see her and Dina here today. And Aaliyah is working at ShopRite, and she's looking toward her future. Amen? Amen? Amen and amen. Any other high school graduates that we should mention today? Okay.
Caroline Brannon graduated from a Wall High
You need
school.
To, yeah.
Caroline Brannon graduated from Wall High School, and her sister Kylie graduated from the University of Delaware. They're my nieces.
And they're members here.
And they're members.
And they're members here. Okay, and we have some eighth graders. Any eighth graders here that would like to stand up and say hello? No, okay. Shane Hagerman, Ben MacArthur, Joe Filsberry, yes? No? Oh, excuse me. He's older than that. So, amen? Amen. Will all those who have been notified that they received a Norris Scholarship come forward, and our president of our trustees, Mark Morris, will be, I just turned it off. Oh, no, there it is. Will be presenting the Norris Scholarship. So would all those present, come on up. Here you go. And those of you behind me? Okay. And parents, I know some of you are here. You could sit in the front row, and then we'll grab you. So can the students come up? All right. It's good to see you here. Okay, Mark, take it away.
All right, good morning, guys.
It's on. You have to be real close.
So Reggie kind of hesitated with my last name. It's Morris, not Norris, no relation. But it's great to be able to do this again every year. Congratulations to the graduates and those of you that haven't or going into college. We hopefully have some help for you here, but I think Nancy perfectly summed it up what this is all about. It's great to be able to give financial assistance, but also to show the church is behind you guys, wherever you may be. And there's looks like you guys are kind of spread out around here. So starting with Jake Brown, sophomore at University of Florida.
Yeah, here. You want to give hand him the microphone?
Here you go. Want to say something about what you're doing?
Put it right up here.
Okay. Going to University of Florida. I really appreciate the money. Really helps me, and I love knowing that you guys have my back. You guys sent me like a few letters when I was down there, and really made me happy. So thank you.
Amen.
Matthew Del Grippa.
I'm currently a rising sophomore at Villanova University, studying economics and minors in business and accounting. So thank you again every year for the scholarship. It really means a lot, and it helps me a lot, as Villanova is not cheap. I'm always glad to be here and sing and help out. So I'm glad to hear that you guys always have my back and all of our backs. So thank you so much.
Amen.
AJ? Can't even put his guitar down.
I'll just hold it. Yeah. Howdy. I'm going to be a rising senior at Stevens. I know I'm not the only one on this stage. But I don't need to say that the last year was not easy, obviously, for any of us. So just to think that, you know, the church had us in mind, especially given everything that we've all gone through, it really does mean a lot. I know the letters I received from Mrs. Farley were always nice. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We have Kate Pastorchek.
So I said something a couple weeks ago, so I'll keep it short. I'm majoring in professional writing at Kutztown University. I'm going to be a rising junior, and I'm minoring in musical theater. And I just wanted to thank everyone for always having my back and always giving me a home here at the church. So thank you guys so much.
Dina Richards.
Hi, I'm a rising senior at Stevens with AJ. I'm majoring in mechanical engineering, and this summer I'm really just working on like upping my skills, computer-aided drawing, coding, because that's like what I want to do with the future. Super grateful for the scholarship. It'll definitely go a long way.
Thank you. And Shannon Richards.
Shannon is a junior, I think, going to Coastal Carolina University in the medical field, and she's down there now. So hi, Shannon.
Keith Fantuano.
Keith is a senior at Rowan University, majoring in biomedical engineering. He's also a runner, so he's on the track team at Rowan and doing very well.
Jordan Vigiano.
I'm going to be a sophomore at OCC, and I'm planning to go on to FAU afterwards, and I'm very thankful for this. It really means a lot, and it's very helpful, so thank you.
Awesome.
Rosemary Vandernet, excuse me.
Rosemary and Vandernet and Brianna Zarachek and Sarah Kimek and Brian Michigan were not able to be with us, but they sent us a video so that we can have an update from each of them.
Hey everyone, my name is Rosemary. I just graduated from Biotechnology High School, and in the fall I will be attending Duquesne University as a Forensic Science and Law major on a pre-medicine track. I just wanted to take the time to thank the Board of Trustees and my entire church family for giving me this opportunity and this wonderful scholarship.
Hi, I'm Brianna Zarachek. I'm going to be a junior at Stockton University this fall. I'm a health science major with a concentration in pre-communication disorders. I would really like to apologize for not being able to make it here today. I really wish that I could be, but I sadly have to work. I want to thank all of you for the unconditional love and support all of you have given me throughout my journey with school, and especially for the scholarship. I really appreciate it more than you guys know. I wish you all the best summer, and I hope to see you all soon.
Hello, my name is Sarah Kinnack, and I'm a student at the University of Delaware. I'm incredibly honored to be selected as a recipient for the William Norris Scholarship, and I'd like to take a moment to thank my church family and my amazing grandmother for accepting it on my behalf. Unfortunately, I can't be there today because we're on a family vacation, but I'd like to tell you all how my first year at Delaware went and what I'll be up to this summer. As a member of the cross country and track team at Delaware, I was really busy, especially with adding a second major in cognitive science in addition to my first in computer science. Though it was a very chaotic year with all the regulations from COVID, I was able to compete and meet a lot of new people through my virtual classes, which was awesome. This summer, I'll be working in a lab through UCLA, which is a speech processing and auditory perception lab, where we'll work on speech recognition for children. So I'm incredibly grateful for this opportunity and excited to see what comes for me in the future. Thank you again.
Hello everyone there at the Manasquan United Methodist Church. I would like to thank the trustees of the William T. Norris Scholarship and to the church family for accepting me for the scholarship. This scholarship always comes in handy every year. Penn State's an expensive school, and I love going there, so this really helps me to continue doing what I love, which is studying meteorology. This next year, I will be doing a lot of work in the studio, practicing to hopefully become a broadcast meteorologist someday. So, thank you.
We'd like the parents to stand, and we have a Brian Michigan's mom, Stacy, and Brianna's dad, Daryl, and Jordan's mom, Amy, and we've got the Browns are here, so stand up. And anybody else? Oh, and the Del Grippos are here. Amen and amen. Yeah. So did you want to say anything else?
No, just congratulations, guys. Thanks all for applying, taking the time.
Oh, everybody come forward so George can get your picture. Oh, wait, just JJ come forward, okay.
And just real quickly while he's doing this, thanks to Laura DeGraw, Lynn Bishop, and Nancy Etnies for taking the time to do these interviews. And again, everyone that contributed so that we're able to do this year in and year out. I know it was a strange year for them, and it's great that we're able to keep doing this. So thank you.
Amen. Please give the text to the parents. You can give them the envelope.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You know, as they go back to their seats, let us pray. Lord God in heaven, we pray your blessing on each of these students, those online, those on video, those present. Bless them, hold them close, Lord. Guide and direct them. Tell them that our prayers and our thoughts are with them every day. And Lord, it's been a very hard year for all of them. And we just thank you that you have been present with them and so alive and vital in each of their lives. In Jesus' name, all God's people said, amen and amen. Are we not blessed? Yes. Amen. Amen. Okay. Well, I surprised two people this morning and asked them to do a dramatic reading for me. And so, okay, Matthew's, huh?
That's what you do best.
I do it best, she says. All right, many of you already know that. So, so Matthew, would you go first? Matthew is going to, I don't know how to get it to go green. Oh, there it is. All right. And he's going to be being a disciple.
Where am I standing?
Right there. Is okay. That good?
Sounds great.
It's wonderful. Thank you.
From the frying pan and into the fire, my mother would always say, how her words ring truer than true in my ears today. I had no clue what it would be like to follow the stranger, but something within me told me I had to go, even if it felt chaotic or dangerous. Finally, peace, deep down. I'm a fisherman, and I have never been more excited to see the sea. The seagulls singing a song as they dip and dive through the sky, tame waves lapping at the edge of a boat, and silence in the wake of utter chaos. As the mist lifts and we begin to see the next shore, I can't believe the crowd that has gathered. I don't second guess it for a minute. They're here to see, to speak to receive healing from Jesus. I'll give him that. He knew how to draw a crowd. Once I was finally able to hear myself think, I attempted to gather my thoughts. Instinctively, I found myself willing to follow along with no real agenda other than proclaiming that this man was the Son of God. And that meant going everywhere with everyone. We tethered the boat and stepped out onto what was already crowded land. I wondered what Jesus would do next. How would we get through? Almost immediately, a man approached us and begged Jesus to save his daughter. Okay, well, there was our next destination, the house of a leader in the synagogue. But as we turned that way, I should have known, another interruption to set the path. Jesus called them holy interruptions. I call them unplanned headaches. Jesus asked, who touched him? Was he serious? There had been at least 300 people here. For all he knew, it was me. But he said it was different. He'd felt the power leave him. How do you respond to that? Just when I thought I knew how to answer him or help him to follow another person, he changed it up on me. Turns out a woman fessed up to grabbing his robe. She looked awful, pale and weak. When she made herself known, Jesus replied, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed. If I wasn't lost before. We continued on our original path to the leader's home, and it seemed we were too late. But there too, Jesus demonstrated power, compassion, and authority. Sometimes, I looked at him in utter amazement. I didn't know how long this would last or if I would ever return home, but I knew I would never be the same again.
And now the risk taker.
For 12 years, I've been praying and hoping for a change. I went from doctor to doctor, and no one can give me answers. I'm an alien in my own home. I can't fellowship with my sisters and brothers. I'm an outcast because of something beyond my control. I feel worthless and alone. Who is in the middle of that crowd? They say it's Jesus of Nazareth. I heard a lot about him. I heard he was sent from God. Surely he can heal me. But I can't go. I'm unclean. If others see me, I could face uncertain consequences. What do I have to lose? If I never try, I will never be set free. I know what I'll do. I'll just touch his robe. I know I will be healed. No one will ever know. I can't reach him. There are too many people. I'm going to have to crawl. I'm almost there. I did it. His power is amazing. Oh no. He noticed that I touched him. I'm done for. He's not upset? Oh, thank you so much. What an amazing man. I'm free. I was once excluded, but now I'm included. I was once empty, but now I'm whole. I was once enslaved, but now I'm free. I took a risk and gained everything I ever wanted.
All God's people said, amen. 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 Thank you. They do a lot of acting, so I know they wouldn't panic. My granddaughter was with us this week. 6 years old and a bundle of energy, Gary and I are now planning a week of naps. Nap for her is a four-letter word. But it's amazing how much she and I are alike. We don't like interruptions. When we're watching a movie, or playing a video game, or Pokemon Go, don't tell us it's time for lunch, or are we ready to go to the beach, or it's time to get dressed. We will definitely throw you the stink face. You know that face, right? Well, Jesus was on his way to help a 12-year-old daughter of an important person, Jairus, the synagogue leader. But on the way, he was interrupted, touched by an unclean older woman who counted as nothing in the ancient world scenario. How dare she touch a man when bleeding? But there was no stink face from Jesus. Maybe the disciples, but not Jesus. He took her pain and her station and healed them both. She could go back to her family. And the 12-year-old child? Yeah, he healed her too. He brought life through grace, through interruption, through faith. Who is interrupting us with their needs and their cries? Who has been left on the margins because of things beyond our control or their control or anyone's control and is reaching out for a way into the community? How do we make space? How do we stop our busy headlong rush to accomplish our tasks? Which, you know, they're good things that we want to do in and of themselves, but we have to find time to be touched by another's need. As we rush back into our lives and our travels and our family gatherings and our eating out, how do we make space in our hearts for the hurting of this world? Often we say we want to help, but we don't know how or when. We are suspicious of people on the street who ask for money or requests for help through mail or email. And that's right, our red flag should go up sometimes, but we need to be good stewards. I know that. But on the other hand, sometimes we have to let it go and kiss it up to God and do what our heart is telling us. Like collecting baby things for Family Promise. Families who are longing to own their own home or rent their own home or just be in a home. Food for the food pantry to stretch budgets. Our ministerium helps collectively because one church can't always afford to help someone. But together we're stronger and we can mix our money together. And this past week or 2 weeks ago, we put someone in an apartment. We work together. Through Renee's Road to Recovery, we help those who are struggling with health issues, health crisis, with money for gas or lunch at the hospital or whatever they need. And it's not a burden, is it? It's an opportunity for us to share the grace of giving. It is said that C.S. Lewis walked in on an academic discussion about the distinctiveness of Christianity. Those present were about to decide that there was nothing different that set Christianity apart from any other world religion, because they were unable to come up with anything that truly marked our faith and set it apart from the rest. So they put the question to Lewis, and he paused only a moment and said, "That's easy. It's grace. It's grace." Grace is what makes us who we are as followers of Jesus Christ. Grace is what motivates us to respond with love and joy and hope. Grace is what equips us for living in this world and what allows us to help create a sense of community as we seek out other recipients of God's grace. It is what we have to offer the world, nothing of our own, but gifts that come from grace. Grace, that which is not earned. Rosemary and Tyler lead our youth in mission trips with Aaliyah's driving energy. Brianna helps in an assisted living facility. Jordan trained for the community emergency response team. Keith is tutoring. Shannon has faith that brings action to those around her. Dina is learning to make drinking water safe. Kate volunteers at an elementary school. Brian knows God has called him to learn about weather in creation. Sarah volunteers with Special Olympics and the Boys and Girls Club. AJ lifts our worship. Matthew coordinated a food drive. Jake knows his strength comes from worship and is excited to see where his faith will lead him. like Christine and our musicians and singers and ringers last week, sharing the grace of God through their music to lift up our worship. In Corinthians, the Apostle Paul had gone from church to church and could have left out the Corinthian church. They were a mess, with problems and dissension among each other. But he decided to invite them to give, to help the urban church in Jerusalem. He wants them to excel, to participate, to enjoy this generous undertaking. The Greek words for generous undertaking are charis peruska, which probably translates better as abounding grace. The invitation is not to give, but to participate in grace, abounding grace. Paul goes on to explain that this is what Jesus did for us by emptying himself and giving up and giving away that we might know glory, that we might know hope, that we might know salvation. We might be able to give grace away because we have received it. You and I have received that grace. Paul is trying to tell the Corinthians that he is doing them a favor by letting them give. He knows that they, like we, want to know the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. He says, I know that grace, and not only can you know it, but you can live it. Not only can you receive it as a gift, but you can activate it by giving it away, by participating in the ripples of grace that go from person to person, community to community, and bring transformation and experience of the kingdom of God. He ends the invitation by reminding them and reminding us that love needs proof from time to time. Love needs action to really be love, at least the love that Christ calls us to, the love that God expresses, the love the Holy Spirit shares with us. The most famous verse in all of the Bible reminds us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him may not perish but have eternal life. How do we pass on this grace? There's an old Chinese tale of a woman whose only son died. And in her grief, she went to the holy man and said, "What prayers, what magical incantations do you have to bring my son back to life?" Instead of sending her away or reasoning with her, he said to her, "Fetch me a mustard seed from a home that has never known sorrow." A mustard seed from a home that has never known sorrow. "We will use it to drive the sorrow out of your life." The woman went off at once in search of that magical seed. She came first to a splendid mansion, and she knocked on the door and said, "I'm looking for a home that has known no sorrow. Is this such a place? It is very important to me." And they told her, "You've certainly come to the wrong place." And they began to describe all the tragic things that had recently befallen them. And the woman said to herself, "Who is better able to help these poor, unfortunate people than I, who have had misfortune of my own?" She stayed to comfort them. And then she went on in search of a home that had never known sorrow. But wherever she went, from mansion to hovel, and in all other places, she found one tale after another of sadness and misfortune. She became so involved in ministering to other people's grief that ultimately she forgot about her quest for the magical seed, never realizing that it had, in fact, driven out the sorrow in her life. Walking with someone else through their pain can bring good out of our pain. Not that our pain is gone, but when we walk with each other, we have the grief. We have the sorrow. H-A-L-F, have. Make it have. The needs of people become those grace moments, those God winks. Don't miss them. Don't miss them. They are a blessing to give and to receive, to be attentive, to be present, to listen, to be alive and real, like Jesus did and Jesus does through grace. You are the light of the world. A city is set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all those who are in the house. Let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Let your light shine. Give with joy. Whether it's to Renee's, to the church's ministries, to the Norris Scholarship, to Family Promise, to the food pantry. Look for ways that God is calling you today to shine the light. Is it to make a call when you go home to someone who isn't feeling the energy to go out and about? Who isn't ready, is still scared? Walk with them. If you are going through something, share it. Let someone else know that the Lord walks with them because you are walking with them. Amen and amen. God of boundless generosity, we offer our gifts and our lives to you. Help us to hear and heed your Apostle Paul. We long to grow as disciples so that we can grow in generosity. The abundance that we've been given has a purpose in your plan, that we might know the joy of sharing that abundance with those in need. Amen.
Oh, shoot, I forgot my checkbook.
Don't you have the Venmo app?
No.
Oh, I'll show you how to get it. Download the Venmo app and then click the pay request. And then type in Manasquan-UMC and just look for a photo of our church. And then just type in the amount you want to pay.
Okay, hold on, let me see. Okay, there it is. Oh look, if I write 4, then I can say I'm giving it to the church because this church is so awesome. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We have made arrangements with Vanco Services to provide a secure means for you to submit your giving to the church. You can access Vanco through our website at manasquanumc.com. Click on the e-giving tab on the left of the homepage. Once there, you can input your email address and create a password. This will allow you to authorize payments and check your payment history. You can designate your donation to the General Ministries Fund or to a specific fund. Additionally, you can choose a one-time payment or an automatically deducted weekly or monthly payment. To submit your payment, click the Continue button at the bottom of your screen. Your church family thanks you for your generosity.
Bless our gifts as we long for a vision of your kingdom, where loving hearts bring a better balance between abundance and need. In the name of Christ, our teacher and redeemer, we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Our closing song is Hymn of Promise, because God sees, God knows, And in God's perfect timing, he will make it happen. Hymn of Promise.
Just as God's word was sent into the world to heal and redeem, so God sends you into the world this day to be light and love, healing and hope. Go now to be the light of the world. Why? Because we are indeed walking billboards declaring God's glory. May the grace and the peace of God, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer be upon you this day and remain with you always. Amen and amen. Amen. To have you worship with us today, and we have a favor to ask. We are getting ready to have all the tile floors stripped and waxed, and so we need to empty the chapel. Mark Morris is going to be our director, pointing. We're moving everything into the fellowship hall, so if you would like to help us out, that would be awesome. Remember, we have Thursday night worship, and next Sunday is the 4th of July. I don't remember there being a worship service on the 4th of July before, but we will have a time of prayer for our country. So as you come, just know there's going to be a time of prayer for our country. So my friends, God be with you till we see you again. Thank you for worshiping online. God bless. In the chapel. It won't take long. Amen.